A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 24th October, on the front page you have 39 bodies found in truck in London. So this is a vehicle which is believed to be from Bulgaria, and it is suspected to be involved in trafficking. So 39 bodies have been found in this truck in London. And truck driver, he's a 25-year-old man from Northern Ireland. He has been arrested on suspicion of murder. And now local police is working with immigration officials, priorities to try to identify the victims. There are 38 adults and one teenager. Then here you have 70,000 crore BSNL MTNL package cleared. So cabinet has given in principle approval for merger also for BSNL MTNL. Even voluntary retirement scheme proposal has been put forth. So here you can see BSNL, MTNL, they will account for now 10% of the total wireless subscribers and nearly 65% of the wireless subscriber base. So this is, you can see how Vodafone, Reliance, BSNL, MTNL fare. MTNL, you should know, it operates only in Mumbai and Delhi. BSNL across the country. So in wireless, BSNL, MTNL are low, but in wireline subscribers, wired subscribers, BSNL, MTNL come high when Airtel has good coverage. So this actually, under this package, actually 4G spectrum worth 20,000 crore will also be administratively allocated to the two firms. Their debts will be restructured by raising bonds with sovereign guarantee worth 15,000 crore. And voluntary retirement scheme has an outlay of 30,000 crore. So that's the total 70,000 crore. Package. So with these steps, BSNL and MTNL are expected to turn EBITDA, that is earning before interest, tax, depreciation and amortization, positive in the next 2 years. So presently the EBITDA is negative. This is a terminology in economics, you should know. This is earnings before interest, tax, depreciation and amortization. Then this is over 1700 colonies to be regularized in Delhi. So this is Delhi Development Authority, which will start the process of regularizing colonies. Over 40 lakh people living in these colonies are likely to be benefited. Then this is Rabi crop MSP to be hiked for next season. So decision has been taken to increase farmers' income, and Union Cabinet has decided to hike MSP for Rabi crops for the marketing season 2020-21. So these are the winter crops. So the increase is based on the principle that MSP should be at least 1.5 times of all India weighted average cost of production. So this we have seen, that is also controversial because cost of land is not included. So that is there. And this is Justice Mishra again refuses to recuse himself. So this is the case on land acquisition in which the judgment was given by Justice Mishra led bench, a three-judge bench, which was overturning another verdict of the Supreme Court given earlier by a three-judge bench. So question on whether, you know, this can be upheld, and a larger bench looking into it, that is also before a bench led by Justice Mishra himself, and he has been asked to recuse himself quite often, but again it is said he refused to recuse himself. On page 5 you have, Delhi will come to a halt if Bihari stop working for a day. So this is JDU chief, JDU president Nitish Kumar, and Bihar chief minister as such, Nitish Kumar, has given this statement. He says he supports the statehood for Delhi city to enable its holistic growth too. And this is remove all links to videos disparaging Ramdev. So this is Delhi High Court, which has directed social media platforms including Facebook, Google, YouTube and Twitter to remove or disable on a global basis links to a video containing defamatory allegations against Ramdev. So High Court was of the opinion that merely geo-blocking or disabling access to defamatory content to viewers from India would not be sufficient because users can access it by other means. So they want it to be completely, there cannot be any dispute that the offending information would still reside in the global platforms. So, and would be accessible from India. So it wants it to be completely removed. So this is a video which has, Baba Ramdev has approached the High Court contending that several defamatory remarks and information, including videos based on a book titled Godman to Tycoon, The Untold Story of Baba Ramdev, have been disseminated over online platforms. So High Court wants it to be completely removed. On page 8, you have a second century BC main stupa at Thotlakonda Buddhist monastery site in Andhra Pradesh, Visakhapatnam district, crumbled partially due to heavy rains. So the heritage site, which is about 420 feet above sea level, is a major tourist attraction too. So this is the image. So you should know about this. Then on page 9, you have next three PSLV missions will carry 14 small foreign satellites. So Indian Space Research Organization has bagged orders from four international customers. So it will be launching these PSLV satellites now. So you can see it will be PSLV C-47, C-48 and C-49 will be launched in November and December. So in PSLV C-47, ISRO's own CartoSat 3 is the main payload. So these four international customers are also mentioned here. You can see Analytical Space, Spire, IQPS and Clio Space. So Clio Space is from Luxembourg. Then one is from US. Analytical Space is from USA. So these are mentioned here. You can see. Space Flight is another one. So these are private entities which have roped ISRO for launching satellites for them. Space Flight is from USA. Then below you have center to set up peritoneal dialysis service under PMNDP, that is Prime Minister National Dialysis Program. So this will benefit at least 2 lakh people every year. So to bring in equity in patients access to home-based peritoneal dialysis and reducing the overall cost of care and bringing in consistency of practices, pricing and full range of product availability as such, the government has released guidelines for establishing peritoneal dialysis service under the program. On the editorial page, the first editorial is need for balance. So this is regarding the proposed rules for online intermediaries. So the editorial argues that these rules should not infringe on privacy of users. So government wants access to like data from WhatsApp, content from WhatsApp, Facebook, etc., from social media platforms. So but they say these messages are encrypted, but government says we need access to them. We will tackle them and crack them, but intermediaries still argue that these messages cannot be shared, upholding privacy of users. The case is even before the Supreme Court. So this now case, the ruling as such, the editorial says it should not infringe on privacy of users. So security and privacy both have to be balanced. And this is Justin. So this is regarding Canada, Justin Trudeau. He one, but he'll form a minority government. He does not have complete majority. So as he leads a minority government in Canada, Trudeau should be wary of giving up on principles, is what this editorial raises concern. Then this is minding the gaps in India's data infrastructure. So this article says that national discourse can ill afford the danger of being hijacked by the poor quality of data. So data quality has to improve in the country is what this article is arguing for. So National Family Health Survey related data and other data, it needs to be up to the mark so that it can be reliable and of good quality, which can be used. And this is a case against judicial recusal. So this is regarding the controversy which is there on front page too. Justice Arun Mishra refused to recuse himself from the case. Hearing recuse, okay, a judge recusing means he steps down from the bench, that he cannot give a judgment in the case because his own something, personal or something is involved. In this case, it was he himself who was on the bench, which is here, and the same case is being heard by this another bench, whether the earlier bench was correct or not. So he should recuse. But this article says that despite the controversy, Justice Arun Mishra's recusal is not in fact mandated by the law on judicial impartiality. So the law as such does not call for it, but judges on their own have recused themselves in many instances. So this is the case. So details are given of that. And on the OPIT page, you have an election dilemma in Sri Lanka. So this is regarding election, presidential elections, which would take place in Sri Lanka. And this is about rewriting of history, which was called by Amit Shah. And this is treading cautiously on the final Naga peace agreement. So this article says the center should not be rigid in its stance in the final Naga peace agreement, which the state interlocutor is also spoken on. On page 12, you have two public functionaries need a gag, asks Supreme Court. So this is a constitutional bench examining if greater curbs should be imposed on public functionaries to protect the citizens' right to a dignified life. So this is, you know, whether restrictions on free speech and expression of high public functionaries, whether it should be restricted or not, including ministers. A reference to a constitutional bench was made on this issue in 2017. So this is a 5-judge bench led by Justice Arun Mishra, which is examining whether further restrictions are needed on free speech or not. Then, on page 13, you have Modi skips Naam Summit again. So, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu will be representing India at the 19th Naam Summit in Baku, Azerbaijan, marking the second time in a row that Prime Minister Narendra Modi will give the summit a miss. So, Naam is non-aligned movement. So, you should know about it also. Many a times it has been called redundant, not required in present times, because alignment, that aspect came during the Cold War, when the communist Soviet Union and the capitalist USA were two poles in the bipolar world, and countries were aligning to either of the two. But a few developing countries, or rather many developing countries led by India as such, to India, Indonesian president, they decided to be non-aligned, aligning to neither. So that was the Naam summit, which was, you know, Naam movement, which was started, and Naam summits are still held. But Prime Minister Modi has given it a miss for the second time in a row. On international page, you have Hong Kong officially kills extradition bill. So this was one of the 5 demands of protesters in Hong Kong, which has now been accepted and action has been taken. However, China has dismissed reports that it is planning to sack city's ruler, Ms. Lam. So that may not take place, which is another demand of the protesters. And this is EU backs Brexit delay, yet to finalize a date. So EU members have agreed in principle to postpone the date of Brexit beyond the end of October, but has not set a new date yet. And here you have Beijing invites Taliban for intra-Afghan meet. So talks are aimed at ending 18-year war. This is USA opted out of talks. The talks collapsed, but China has now invited Taliban delegation to attend intra-Afghan conference in Beijing. On business page, you have Cabinet eases norms for firms to set up fuel outlets. So Cabinet has approved a new policy wherein retail outlets for fuels can be set up by non-oil companies, and the requirements to set up these outlets have been relaxed. So these are new rules and guidelines. It says this is to encourage private investment. Then on the last page, you have quantum leap in computing as Google claims breakthrough. So Google claims that its machine did a task that could take 10,000 years in 200 seconds. So this is quantum computing, which has been mastered. And that is it. So this is also India's first ever snow leopard survey, which would take place. So population and geographical range of animal will be studied. So India is commissioning this first ever survey to estimate the population and geographical range of snow leopard, which is an elusive and endangered predator. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.